Hello, weapon upgrade tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play XCOM 2 Long War 2 with me, BlueAnkylo. So we are very close to unlocking laser weapons, or at least the beginning of laser weapons. Spoiler alert, we need to go to an advanced laser weapons to get all of them, but you know, that's a good start. Looking at the queue, we've got some AWC, some officer. We're still 8 days away from the room for the power plant. And 2 weeks away from a supply drop. In other base management news, I made my first workstation, which we've got sending drones down here, which is nice. No supplies to build anything else, but if I remember correctly, the plan was a lab and some resistance comms fairly soon, after we get some power, I guess. Although I've got 4 spare power right now, so if I could get the money, I could start building this one or this one right now. If I had the supplies for free. I feel like I only had 15 power the last time I calculated this. I think it actually does not cost any power to upgrade the workshop to send out more drones. Some of the upgrades for some of the buildings do cost you some power. So in between episodes, I've actually taken a bit of a break because last episode was intense. So we've definitely got some people off on wounds for a while, and depending on how I feel, I might consider throwing one of my two scientists into the increased healing rate. I am pretty sure that slows down our research, though. And, you know, maybe the best way to not have people die is to just research lasers and armor and stuff. I know I will certainly be putting a scientist in here permanently at some point, but I think because it does, I did test it out, it definitely lowers your research speed. I think I want to hold off a little bit on that. And the other thing I did is I added a few names. I don't remember exactly which ones got added in. They're probably near the bottom of the list here, so there's still a few more without any proper names, and we will probably want some rookies later on, a fair while from now, to get trained up in a specific class. So I am still looking for new names, keep them coming. Just looking at this list, I've still got maybe 7 or 8 open slots right there, and certainly we'll be recruiting more as time goes along. Now I probably won't be spending supplies for them, at least not like this, but we'll get them from mission rewards every now and then. And if I do want a good recruit, I'll recruit them from the black market for a more expensive cost, but then they can start out at a good level. Okay, so is there anything else to check before we get out to business? Apparently we picked up another Haven operative for West Asia at some point, so let's put them to work. Hopefully they're not actually a faceless. And nice to see New India is fully capped, making some supplies for us for next month. That'll be nice. We definitely need the money, so that's good. You know, if by some chance we get to the new month and no supplies are stolen, then I will kind of know that these two areas are, or at least one area, is no spies, and I can... I could get rid of the Haven agent, or the soldier. I could pull the soldier out and theoretically send them an engineer at some point to make even more money. Okay, well, enough messing around in base. What's the map look like? Like I said, it's been a few days for me, so give me a second here. We're making contact with New Indonesia, which is good, because we need to get to Brazil. I'm a little bit worried that we might not be able to connect up like this, and that we might have to go with the red dot route. Like I said, my test campaign, the first black site was in New Mexico. And I know I had to go from Western US to Eastern US, and then from Eastern US to New Mexico. Like, the connections were different for me than what they're showing here. And we'll find out, though. Once we get to... we'll have to go to Australia anyway. And, I mean, I'll probably still try to go through the New Chile route. So anyway, that's one important thing going on. We also can do a headquarters assault, which I'm not in a big rush to do. Well, I'm in a big rush in a way, but I'm also kind of scared because that network tower mission was You know, if it wasn't for the reinforcements, I think we would have been fine. But we got so bogged down by reinforcements. Now, the difference with the headquarter one, I don't think I've showed this, actually. Oh, probably wasting a couple hours of game time here, technically. But we could start prepping it right now. The thing is, we can send a really large squad. Now, it'll take like a month to infiltrate if we send all 10 dudes. But it's really a tough mission. And I might want to try to pick up like 10 of our best and equip them up with laser guns as soon as we can get them. And then just give it a try. You can infiltrate as long as you want. But I think 10 people will be like 13 days or 15 days. So to get to 200%, which would knock it down a little bit, would take, you know, basically an entire month. So we'll see about that later. Looks like we're going to start with a mission, though. So let's just get this started. I suppose I could spend intel. Spend 15 days infiltrating and then boost it higher with intel. We'll see. We'll talk about that more once we've maybe finished researching lasers. Hopefully this... I should have checked the squad. I forget who's on this mission even. But hopefully this one isn't too bad for a starter mission for today for me. This is just a recovered data cache from a train. Small town outside of Delhi. You know, it should be fun. Hellish Palace. Hopefully this is a full squad and not just two dudes that are supposed to stealth it. Because I'm not sure I've got the endurance for that. Now this looks like a good team. Let's look. Have a look at our dudes. That's a good size squad. Alright, gotta hack that train. We've got a bead on the advent data vault near your position. You guys know how data vaults work. 15 turns to hack it. I guess normally it would be 10, so if you want to be fair... Hush, Bradford. If you want to be fair for me, keep track, I gotta get there in 10 turns without, you know, using my hacking abilities. But anyway, we've got Anna Volkova, or Dust, as our sniper. We've got... I just renamed this guy, I'm pretty sure. Sir Renyok the Bear. So welcome to the team, new person. We've got also a new one. Austin Jackson Betadine. I recognize these because I just typed them in. This one, still no name. Poor Grenadier, no name. Just waiting for somebody to leave a comment. We got Jingles. You guys remember Charlie. He's my medic. Good stuff. We've got Tim Dover. This might be his first mission. I think I renamed him last time I recorded. Looks like our assault. We've got a rookie. Why did I bring a rookie? Two rookies. Alright, so we don't have a very advanced squad. That's important. Did I not even have one shinobi? Ranger. It's nice to have a ranger and stuff. Looks like no shinobis. So we're going to want to use... probably the people that have submachine guns to be our pseudo shinobis, because they're a little bit harder for the enemy to detect and it's less likely he'll mess up. I'm kind of thinking of angling around the outside of the map to get to here. This train station, just given the loadout here, we might be able to hack it from this angle without having to get in there. I have a feeling our specialist could probably hack somewhere over here. And that might have us skip everything on this side of the train tracks, in case that's there. And I totally forgot before I started the mission to check the difficulty or anything. Noob Ankylo here, can't remember what's going on, but yeah, hopefully it's extremely light, because this is certainly not a super high quality squad. So let's get to work. We'll be edging around the outside of the map, I think. Pretty much the smart thing to do, I figure. Technically, you could put one or two people up on the sign, I think. Yeah, there is a ladder over here. So if we get the correct placement, we might get a couple people up high there. You never know. Heading to that location. All right, let's...
copy that.
Let's not spend too much time positioning.
Affirmative.
Oh, this is a... One square of full cover on that truck. Or car, I guess. Kind of strange.
Got it. Moving.
Shotgun. Needs to be a little bit closer to the action. Actually, here comes the action.
Got some hostiles grouped over here.
Alright. That's a nice easy pod to start with. If we have to fight that, that's no big deal. I mean, we're still only dealing with rookies here, so don't get your hopes up too high, but that doesn't look super scary. And the plus side here is we've got a pretty big group. I do have a sniper, so like having a sniper up here could be valuable. They've got death from above. That's the symbol there. So there's not a lot of high ground on this map, so I might end up doing that.
No need to ask twice.
I'm on the move.
Definitely nice to get those extra aim high ground bonuses type deal. Alright, they did not move, so I think that means that they're like the defense pod for the target, although they're pretty far away from it. Most groups patrol around, unless there's some sort of weird bug going on.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
What do I know? Alright. Haven't seen anything yet. We actually still have quite a ways to go. Well, we don't want to accidentally give them vision, so let's sort of keep our distance from the train for now. Alright.
Heading there now.
I mean, I would expect this to be a fairly easy mission, so you know, let's try not to spend too much time just messing around.
Getting it done.
Head over to the corner.
Got it covered.
Get these rooks some cover. There's not much cover over here, is there? I used a lot. You know what? I'm gonna risk standing out in the open because we're so far away. And just to save some time, we'll do a couple open moves. Should be fine. Not like that ever gets anyone killed. Alright. Why am I scouting with my gunner? Don't ask me. They're pretty fast. 13 movement is pretty good, I guess.
That's affirmative.
Really should be scouting with someone with lower detection, though. So we've got this building, so that's some high ground options. We could get up here. We'll probably consider it. I'm open to that idea.
Already there.
Alright. Keep dashing up a bit. Save a little bit of time.
Good to go.
It's not like every single move you make needs to be into full cover or anything. It's fine. Every breath you take needs to be in full cover, though.
On the move.
So this is probably the section of a mission that I would consider cutting out in the future. Haven't quite gotten to that point yet. But if I do end up cutting sections of episodes out, this is the kind of stuff we might not have to see. So, that's not the same pod we saw back here, is it? Probably not. So this is like two pods of three. I would expect at least one more. But like, if we get past this building, we could skip that group as well. If it's possible.
Position confirmed.
Might not want to wait around for too much longer if they're patrolling towards us. Actually, this is a pretty safe move because it's got cover in two directions. Could it open with that? Alright, Ranger. Always nice to get a good setup.
Solid copy. On the move.
We do have a tower we could consider hacking. Map alert would be bad, and then the bonuses are pretty weak, so I'm not gonna worry about that.
Got it covered. Time to motor.
I just don't want the patrol to catch us now. Now that I've sort of committed to running past them, so everyone's got a dash. So I changed my mind about climbing on top of the building because I'm pretty sure the patrol would have seen us if I tried to head up here. And also, as it turns out, not great cover in the direction of the most likely enemy targets, so there is that. Alright, so my theory is that from here we might be able to hack from range, which would make things pretty simple.
Closing on target position now.
I haven't seen anything on this corner, so we're pretty safe, I think. So I would expect we've seen two enemy groups. You know, maybe the third one's like right around here or something? It's hard to say for sure. Try to avoid the civvies.
Will do.
For now.
Got it.
Okay, this is our specialist. Maybe next turn we'll be close enough to hack. That'd be crazy.
Moving on target location. Will do.
I'm just gonna overwatch, I guess.
Roger. I've got my eyes on. Let's do this.
Sniper's definitely not the speediest. There's no Windrunner here. 10 movement, yeah. Alright, so probably have to move a bit closer than back here. So let's do this carefully again.
Position confirmed.
Still no enemies. We'll move that close this turn. Okay, so there's a turret. But one turret is not enough to frighten me off. We still don't have a line of sight on the data, or else we would have got a little sort of activation cutscene for that.
That's affirmative.
This is getting a little bit too close for comfort. I'm not sure if moving up like that was necessarily the best idea. But I haven't had any sound pings, and we have seen two patrols already.
Moving.
So, you know, I'm pretty sure we're on...
I need to ask twice.
Like, we're in another corner, so nothing should be sneaking up on us. Yeah, I really want to make sure we don't accidentally activate here. So I'm going to do this all careful-like.
Running.
Would be a huge mistake to get the civilians to yell at us.
Moving to Overwatch. Eyes on the prize, moving to Overwatch.
Okay, that was actually close. Well, there's a few people close enough to hit the turret. That's not a huge surprise. Just make sure you're in cover if we're that close to the turret. Oh, forgot about the sniper. Right. Well, you can just be at the back, I guess, Anna. Alright, alright. We found the defense pod, so we'll have to deal with these guys, which is probably what we'll do now. This is like the boss group. There's two groups of three, and then this is like the alien leader. But we can definitely take that out, right? And they did move close enough that they basically got us, so we don't have a lot of choices. And we're going to get the turret as well. So we might use... we might save the specialist specifically to one-shot the turret. Two armor points. They're pretty hard to kill early on with just normal guns. We could open with a good shot. Reasonably good. I wish I had that high ground, steady weapon type stuff. We'd have a much better chance. You know, because we've got so many rookies here, what I think I want to open with is just a flashbang. Now, I know this is not great cover for you, but you are just a rookie.
Position.
So you're just going to move up to here and flash them. That way, no matter what happens, they'll be weakened, and hopefully we'll be able to get a couple kills anyway. I'm not counting on much out of these guys, basically. Now, we need to be careful not to activate any other pods this turn, if I can help it. Oh, those guys did not get good cover. That was not smart of them. Also, I might consider calling evac now, because it's going to take three turns, and it's likely we'll have killed these guys and hacked in three turns. How about our sniper? Any good shot? Well, I think we take her 49. I mean, we could holo target something, but I'd rather take the only good shot she's got. She doesn't have steady weapon or anything useful yet. And you got the hit. Very nice. One down. Three to go. Or was that... Yeah, yeah. That was not the Viper. Okay. So we definitely should be able to kill those two without too much trouble. And my assault... Probably just shoot the Viper in the back. I wonder if I stand there, if it will still count as a flank, because he should step over and shoot, but... We also have some reasonably good high ground here. Like, that spot, these two spots will be really good at killing those guys. Specialist. So if you're fast enough to get up here... We have two people, I could get... Well, the gunner can get up into the corner, even. A grenadier... Yeah, I got lots of people that can make it up there. I mean, the only worry is that maybe we activate another group by doing that. Theoretically, we've got another person who can, point-blank shotgun here as well. Alright, well, they've got... One of them's got 3 HP. So we're going to open with the submachine gun user. We're not going to have to... We're not going to throw any grenades here, I don't think. That's fine. That means the specialist can hack from up here, actually. Yeah, yeah, well, central. We'll get there. We got lots of time. So I want to take the submachine gun shot on the person they're most likely to kill in one hit. And they did just enough damage. Perfect.
Only the best.
And are we going to continue to get lucky like that? Let's send up the other rookie. Should still get the flank shot, even though... I think this is something they changed from XCOM EU to XCOM 2. I don't think you used to be able to step on or over an ally like this. Like, it's only a flank if you're shooting from this square. And we're getting the flank bonuses, which means I'm pretty sure we're basically allowed to stand in that tile even though someone's there. We got the grays at 92%. Yeah, gross. Okay, we're not going to use the medic's specialist attack yet. The gunner could also flank from relative safety over here. For the Viper. And the infantry could probably kill that guy. And maybe we just use the assault as an emergency kill for something. Because I don't want to put him here and have an enemy pod attack us and get a free shot on him on a flank. So we're going to open with the flank on the Viper. Good shot too, but you've got a chance to kill the Viper in one hit. Oh, you got a crit even, but not a kill. That was really close though. Good try. Alright, so then... We've really only got like two left. And the Ranger is not gonna get a great shot on the... on the snake for the same reason the assault won't. So what I do is I put him over here to get the shot, the flank on Mr. here. And we really, I don't think we can afford to miss here. Oh, it might only do 2 damage. Oh no, I didn't check. I thought walk fire would do enough damage there. I was, dang it. Oh, how's our hack? I mean, we could try to hack it. But I think we have to go for the guarantee kill. Dang it. Well, I messed that all up. They're not close enough to grenade them both. Who's the least likely to cause us problems if we leave alive? The gunner has 3 aim, because he's been flashbanged and he's almost dead. The snake has 12, so technically the snake is more dangerous. Alright, what we're gonna do is just gonna grenade the snake. Yeah, that's fine. We only need to do one damage. I don't think I've ever seen a grenade do zero damage in this game, so we should be okay. Alright. Totally fine. And... we're just gonna kill the turret. Well, we could kill this guy too, technically, but the turret will get a good shot on us if we don't kill it. What I could do is aid protocol someone. I mean, he's got three aim. If he hits anybody, I call hacks. So let's not worry about aid protocol this turn. We'll save that for later. If he hits anybody with 3%, I'm gonna quit. Just straight up quit. Let's playing forever. Throw my computer away. Zero mobility, three aim. What's he supposed to do? What are you gonna do, Gunner? You think that's gonna save you? I have bad news for you, my friend. The bear, Sir Renyok, is gonna tear you to pieces. Probably. He might miss. Alright, got a crit on a snake, and you got a kill on a basically ineffectual gunner. Alright, so... oh, what I forgot last turn was to call evac. That's my bad. So let's make sure we can hack this turn. Don't really want to move that way, because, you know, aliens. Move that far. Alright, now was that square good enough? Nope. Nope. We have to move up here to one of those squares. Okay, that's fair. And I just hop back down here for now. Let the specialist do her thing.
Back in.
Okay. I guess that one square I was looking at was not the right one.
Let's do this.
Kind of strange angles here. Weird. I mean, I guess we'll stand out in the open if it's the easiest way to do this, but that's just, it's really weird that we could see it from here. But not this square, which should have better vision into the train. Well, whatever. If that square will do, that square will do. I don't like standing out in the open, but... try to leave a couple overwatches to protect her. Alright, we will go for the small intel cache. As much as PCSs can be good, I'm not gonna really bank on them very much. A lot of them are just trash. And that's just a common one anyway. Hey, we got one! Would not have got the PCS. So there's a little bit of intel, that'll help. Thank you. And that's job done, basically. Now, we could stick around and probably clear the map. Probably wouldn't be that hard. Let me, let's get out of here, basically. The plan is to get out. Don't call the Sky Ranger. Could call it up there. That'd be kind of funny. No, we'll call it back here where it's relatively safe.
Can I get an evac here?
It's four turns away. Yeah, I definitely should have called that last round.
This is Firebrand. Evac request confirmed. Hold tight.
So we'll probably have to fight off at least one of the enemy waves. Let's get the sniper a little bit closer. Surely they're coming to fight us, right? Don't call me Shirley. Well, I mean, I'm not going to make it easy for them. They want to fight, they got to come to me.
On Overwatch.
Wouldn't mind having the infantry in a good Overwatch spot. Yeah, it's not like it's not like the Grenadier with the submachine gun is going to have a good actual shot, so we'll just cycle them back.
Come get some. Affirmative.
With the best aim and the most likely to get a hit.
Affirmative. Covering now.
And just keep moving the sniper over for now. Here they come. All right. So this was the first pod we saw, because they've got the drone. Wow, we got a graze on 7%. Well, we're probably not gonna hit anything else. Okay. You guys, this was really good, really lucky. I don't care if you kill anything. The fact that you got that 7% graze. I don't think he should just get a free Overwatch, though. That's taking it a little bit too far. Are we actually gonna be able to hit this guy? I can get up to about a 70% shot here. I'm actually gonna move Grenadier out of the way. The reason I'm doing this is so that on the final turn, whenever we're gonna evac, we can still take a shot with the sniper. Don't worry about that guy. This guy's almost dead, but because he's on Overwatch, I'd like to try to kill him first. Alright, and then pretty sure walk fire ends your turn. Yeah, it says ends turn, so we can't walk fire and then take a shot. We could take a shot, but then we wouldn't have enough ammo for walk fire. So would we rather take, yeah, one at 69 is gonna be better than two at 39, I think. I should have reloaded first though. But wow, we still only got the graze. Would be nice to get some loot, but probably not going to be able to pull that off. He's going to pull you out of range. This guy will have to come towards us. I should have maybe considered a smoke grenade too, actually. But I have a feeling this guy will run into our Overwatch and just die. Even though we're only in half cover, it's not like the safest location. Should have considered smoking the big group, but we're gonna hit him. Why'd you turn your gun last second? All right, we got him. I had a feeling someone would get the kill. So the question is, do I bother trying to get that loot? We could just leave next turn, or we could be greedy and go for loot. Let's see if anything activates if we move up this far. Oh, there they are! Wow, those guys were sneaky! They snuck right up on us! That was actually a good surprise. Got me. He got me good. They can climb over the train. Thinking of running and gunning and just killing this guy, this fool. Are we going to be able to kill anybody else, though? Like, 34%, huh? Alright, we're going to fight this group. We're not going to run away. Now, I was kind of hoping that would be a flank there. We can AoE suppress this side. You're going to reload.
Oh yeah.
All right. Play a little bit ballsy. If the civilians weren't in the way, well, actually, would I rather go point blank and risk getting flanked? Yeah, I'd rather go point blank and risk getting flanked. Because this guarantees the kill, I think. And also, we should get his loot. And the goal of this encounter was loot. This is the greedy battle. Good job, Wendigo. Hey, not bad. I like my scopes. Not just the tech guys. Take a 65. We'll probably take that. Let's see. We also have combat protocol. This is like the last group, I think. Let's see if there's any good shots or flashbangs from here. No flanks. So I think, just for security, let's see if we can flash all three of these, or at least the two. Oh, yeah, we can get all three. I feel like that kind of, you know, now I can do whatever I want. I don't need to worry about it too much. I still like to kill them all, but now, like, we're pretty safe. All right, we're going to take the infantry with a walk fire. Might be able to kill them if we're lucky. Did not get lucky, but we could use combat protocol to get that kill.
Absolutely.
Oh, look at this grenade. I actually kind of don't want to kill that gunner. The guy that's suppressed. But I might kill him. Might destroy his cover though with Sapper. That's kind of what I'm hoping. In which case, the suppression was kind of silly. Oh, we destroyed some loot. I was hoping it would do like one damage because it was in the corner of my shot, but you know how it goes. These guys are basically dead. Take a poor shot. Kill one for sure. Probably kill them both for sure, honestly.
Sure thing.
Just kind of playing around, having some fun. These fools.
This is for you.
Just throw some grenades at the train. And, oh, that was the one we could have seen. What if I can actually combat protocol this other one? Probably not. Kind of counting on the medic getting the final kill there. Whoops. Should have thrown the grenade at the other guy. Well, I guess that's all we got, huh? Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Let's do this.
Throw some smoke down. Yeah, that'll be important.
In position.
Can't move far enough to even grab the loot. Dang it. Alright, well, that's fine. I'm not really that worried about this one disoriented, almost dead trooper. But I'm pretty sure we could have killed him with a little bit better grenading. Yeah, he's just scared. He's a little scaredy grenade.
This is Firebrand.
Scaredy trooper. Oh, now you get reinforcements, huh? Alright, well, we're actually not going to be able to leave this turn if I want to pick up the loot. And I want the loot. Two scopes? Take it.
Sure, the docs will want to see this.
They will.
Good copy. Moving on target.
So you'll be able to dash out next turn from here. Hopefully you can get this kill. Nice to have a couple overwatches for the reinforcements. Oh yeah, you just demolish that guy. Beautiful.
Did you see that one?
Alright, that's everybody. So all that's left is to evac. So we might as well just get a couple overwatches, because there is one group of reinforcements coming in, and I'd appreciate being able to kill a couple.
Not a problem.
They should not get any free actions. So it shouldn't really matter where we stand. Like, they could flank us, but they shouldn't get a free hit.
Scanning.
Shouldn't. Oh, you know, I slightly messed up there. The sniper was supposed to be inside of the exit point. So you're actually going to lose your cover, just so that, and you're not going to get an overwatch, just so you can shoot and then basically get out. Alright. Sounds like they're flanking us. I'm not particularly worried, though. This has been a pretty fun mission. Nice and easy to make up after that network tower. Oh, they landed close. Oh, you guys are going to get messed up. I'm glad we didn't overwatch the sniper. She would not have hit anything. They landed right on our evac. Well, yeah, that was a poor decision. There's one of them. We didn't kill this guy. Why not? I think he was stuck. He couldn't even move. That's crazy. Alright, who wants to kill this dude, I guess? You know what? I don't think Charlie's got any kills. I mean, you need a crit or something. Maybe we'll let one of the submachine guys weaken him a little bit. Actually, we'll halter. We'll go all out here. We'll holo target him. Because I use that ability so often. And then we'll let one of the submachiners. It would be. It's possible they'll steal the kill. Yeah, but I didn't think it was likely. And then we'll use the medic to try to get some experience. Because I don't think the specialist has killed anything. Okay, I didn't like how you're aiming your gun there, but you managed to shoot him in the head anyway, so it's all good. I was getting a little worried when they pointed their gun straight up.
Absolutely.
Alright, good fun. I wonder if we could have taken him with us if we just evac'd all together. Like, we just click that button while he's in the evac point with us. Just alright, let's go. Should have been able to kidnap that guy, honestly. Like, really should not have been that difficult. I feel like interrogating some of them would be worth it. Oh, I missed one. I'm sorry about that.
On your order.
Sorry, Betadine. You didn't get to go out with your friends. You're special. You get to go by yourself.
All surviving Xcom operatives are secure.
Firebrand, you mean all Xcom operatives secure. That was a good mission. We actually killed everything. We had the option to bug out early if we needed, but we didn't have to take it. I don't think the enemy even got to take a shot. No one was under fire. Apparently we hit every shot we took. It doesn't count Overwatches. And Grazes count as a success. I guess that's okay. I still also think that they're not always that accurate. I think if you reload, it doesn't keep track properly either. Like, reload, not reload your gun, but reload the save. Just in case you're confused.
I'm certainly impressed.
Thanks, Tigan. Alright, well. Not bad. Got some kills for the rooks. Got some promotions. What do we decide for rangers at corporal? I guess double shot being a little bit better is good. Suppression, just, I don't know, I'm just not a huge fan of it. Gunner, hail of bullets, there is no competition. I mean, Shredder is certainly good, but there's competition, it's just not good enough. Yes, I think this is our first Corporal Grenadier. So if you're going to be going with explosive grenades, you want a free explosive grenade. So the heavy ordnance gives you an extra grenade, basically. As long as you use your an explosive grenade in your grenade slot, you get plus one. Otherwise, you could get, I think this is plus one damage reduction. 1 point of armor passively is not a bad one, but one free grenade is better. Means I can start tossing them out a little bit more frequently. Let's see, assault. Pretty good mobility. Let's just keep stacking the breacher type stuff, because eventually these are really, well, I don't know about untouchable, but close combat and close encounters and close combat are pretty much my favorite. We'll talk about these more later on. I think I mentioned before trench gun's cool, but most of your assault shots are point blank, and getting that crit there can really help out. It's possible you could take Brigham on for more crit damage too, technically. And because they're rookies, we'll wait till we get back to base so I can pick their class. So we picked up a suppressor, an autoloader, and 2 scopes, and 10 intel. Not terrible. Might be an intel package as well if we're lucky. So let's go level up those rooks. I'm just going to keep calling them rooks. Hopefully that's not super annoying. Probably annoys me more than you guys. So they're like perfectly average statted characters with low willpower, but good, reasonably good aim. I don't know what classes I needed. I've kind of lost track. So we've got 5 assaults, 5 grenadiers, 1, 2, 3, 4 gunners. So we should probably pick a gunner. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rangers. One, two, three, four sharpshooters. So maybe a gunner and a sharpshooter, but they're not that good at aim. One, two, three, four, five, six shinobi, but two of them are wounded, so it's really only like five. One, two, three, four, five specialists, and one, two, three, four, five technicals. So gunner and sharpshooter are the only ones sort of missing out. I mean, they'd both be reasonably good gunners. You know what? We'll take one of each just to keep them balanced. We'll make our most accurate one into a sniper, because I feel that's only appropriate. It's not like, you know, your aim with one of those heavy cannons, I feel like, as much as it is important, it maybe feels like it shouldn't need to be, because you just fire, like, thousands of bullets and kill stuff. You don't have to be specifically accurate for that. You could actually have a low aim gunner that just focused on suppression and destroying cover and stuff, but they still wouldn't be as good at, like, a high aim gunner is certainly helpful. So anyway, two more rookies promoted up. And let's see if we got any cool rewards. We get some supplies. That's better than some of the rewards we've had. So we'll definitely pick that up. Is that more important than contact? Probably, because then I can start, potentially, I might be able to start building a new building in my base. So let's see. We should have enough time before the next infiltration. So before we end the episode, let's see if we can get the base management going a little bit stronger. Lasers! We got our first laser rifle, everybody. So you can only make the SMGs, the pistols, and the rifle versions. And we got one free laser rifle. Pistols we haven't even used yet at all. I don't know. Maybe one day. SMGs is actually quite a low priority for laser weapons, because the people that are equipping SMGs aren't the ones that I expect to do a lot of damage on or have good aim, so it's kind of a waste, sort of. But the rifles will be valuable. Shoot, we need more crystals. So I do think we keep focusing on the lasers, but this means we have to render a core first.
I had assumed you'd make that research a priority.
Oops.
I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Thanks, Tigan. Thanks. Alright, let's pick up our loot.
Strategic resource.
Or just, you know, really quickly research that. It takes definitely less than a day. Oops. So, stacking up your research bonuses does seem to help with all of the, your research bonus, I think, does help you render quicker, I believe. Even though it just says one day. I think it would be smart if these things broke it down to the hour. You know. I mean, I guess it's an estimated time, but for things that are so quick, it should say like half a day or a quarter day or, I don't know, something. Probably just go with laser weapons. Yeah.
I foresee a number of valuable applications from this.
Thanks, Tigan.
I'll have a report.
I.e. shooting things in the head with lasers. It's a valuable application. So we managed to get 79 supplies, which puts me pretty close to a new building territory. The trouble with contacts is I'll have to be building a... I might just keep it to build laser weapons, honestly. Like, I'd like to spread out our contacts, but I have to build a radio tower to really do that efficiently for intel. Which we could afford. We've got the intel for it. But every laser weapon... I mean, let's just go have a quick look at how much these things are going to cost. Every laser rifle is 20 supplies, and I need the crystals too, so like right now I can only make one more. Yeah, we're going to be quite short on Illyrium crystals, actually. I'm going to get 8 or so from the core, but then we're going to spend a bunch of it to get the rest of the laser guns. I think that the armor just requires supplies and alloys though, so it's kind of a way to balance those. And it really would be nice to start building some tracer rounds as well, but again, crystals. And the AP rounds are okay, just ignores 2 damage. Tracer rounds are plus 5 aim. The laser weapons are also plus 5 aim. So you can start stacking up pretty good bonuses. And in case you didn't know, XCOM 2 weapons and stuff are crafted instantly. Let's check the back black market. Just want to have a quick look before we go back to making contact. I mean, theoretically, we could buy Ludmilla, who I'm pretty sure is bald because she died on the mission to rescue her. I'm not sure if it's the same last name, but... And unfortunately, things like crystals are quite expensive. It wouldn't be a terrible idea to buy a suppressor either, but... I think I'd rather have more laser rifles. So... I'm just going to put off researching drones for a while. We might need the alloys, so hold on to these. Definitely going to need the Illyrium crystals, so I don't want to sell those. And it's a terrible idea to sell your guns. I kind of miss the original XCOM Alien Defense, or UFO Defense, that is to say, where you could actually manufacture weapons. It takes time to build them, but then you could sell them for a small profit, like... I like that mechanic rather than just losing money to sell them, basically. So yeah, we'll just sell the drones for now. Gives me a little bit more money. And that just makes it a little bit easier to build some lasers. Yeah, that's fine. Two missions on the way. We will want to start headquarters assault, although I might want to finish the advanced laser weapons first. Yeah, I broke down the core and I still only had one left, that's right. Maybe I should have broken down a second core, just... Actually, I could do that. What's more important, getting a couple more laser rifles? It actually would be more beneficial to get them early on, I guess. And I know this goes quickly. We'll switch back to advanced laser weapons, you know, in a second. But I'd rather start equipping my rangers with laser rifles, at least. Alright, we got plus one grenade damage. That's fun. So, grenadier, right. I was still wondering whether or not this is a bug or not, but... we've already got boosted cores via hacks. I wonder if you take it twice, does it do two damage? That's a good question. What if I took it twice? Also, grazing fire is pretty awesome as well. That's pretty good abilities. Let's see who's next for AWC perks. What about the wife? Damn good ground's not bad. Keeping her alive might be the best idea. I like going for the offensive ones early, but like plus one mobility is so nice. Who is that anyway? That's me? I get to run faster, and I can get, I actually didn't mean to click that. It was like I hit enter by accident. Yeah, those are both really good. Move faster and low profile. Man, all right, I'm training myself. I'm gonna go for some aerobic training here. Yeah, gotta prioritize the blue. Something at 100%. Yeah, so technically we can do this mission, although we could probably get it down to extremely light if we're just patient. Alright, got the Illyrium core for laser weapons. Let's continue actually getting the good laser weapons.
Commander, I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
7 days is not terrible though, not bad at all. And our next... Our next officer, Sylvanus, ready to go. So, how are our squads looking in terms of officers? The ninjas do not have an officer yet, unless Sylvanus is meant for them. We've got Shinga for the noob tube. We've got the Seraph for the glitch. We've got Lady Blue. So I think that means I was meant... to send the newest officer to the ninjas. So let's give her over. And for now, we'll pull their old specialist away. Sorry, Jingles. You'll have to find a new squad. But I want them to start gaining leadership bonuses for running with the same officer. So you've got to sort of set these up a bit ahead of time if you can. What is glitched missing? They've only got 7 people on their squad. Missing... technical. Do I have a technical not in a squad? I do. Oh, I can't assign him. Right. Was I having like some weird bug? Maybe when they come back from the mission, I'll be able to assign them their technical. And then we can start building our 5th squad here fairly soon. So I should reassign as 2 shinobis. We've got like a spare shinobi right now, which is good. Save the technical. Yeah, so this is like half a squad. We don't have everybody yet. Arshlog is set for glitched. Technically have a couple advisors kind of, you know, out of the rotation for now. Don't worry, you guys, I'll move you back in before too much longer. I want to get to the end of the month, see if there's any more spies, and then I might pull you out at that point. So that means we should, if I'm just going to stick with specialists for officers, we should send in Charlie next. That's all I was really trying to narrow down. So then I've got like 5 officers ready to go and they can all start gaining their bonuses. And then we can start getting to level 2, like we can start getting first lieutenant training as well. Oh, some of these would be great. Can't look at that. Can't waste my money. Guess we're pretty much ready to end the episode. Let's see if I can make contact first, seeing as just a second away. Super loud. Just believe me when I say the Sky Ranger dropped down, said hello to some people living in tents, and now we're friends. Oh, good. The red dots moved. All right. That's promising. Because that's the route I wanted to take. I wonder why I had such a hard time on my test campaign. Just connecting up. Okay, so we at least start with 6 here. Sometimes you start with less than 6, which is rough. Also, a relatively easy starting area. I think... but we're definitely not going to worry about supplies to start with. The question is, do I focus on intel for missions or just 100% recruiting for a little while until we've got more people? Honestly, I think I want a few more missions. Like one person on recruit, and I should assign a new advisor. So for now, our spare shinobi can be their advisor. And that does help. I'm pretty sure that helps us recruit. So yeah. I figure because it's at Advent Strength 1, it'd be nice to get a couple easy missions here if we can get it. And also because we'll probably be liberating New India fairly soon, they won't be actually giving us missions after that. So, it's kind of my logic. Alright, well, I think we'll be ready to go for this mission next episode. Let's see if we can get it to 125% here at the end of today's. Alright. So, also... I mean, that was the end. That was exactly how long we had. So, we'll definitely be doing this one next episode. Looks good. We got it down to extremely light. Another intel package. This will be the glitch squad. So it's only 7. I need to remember to assign them their tech after the battle. And that will be fun. So thanks for watching, folks. Hope you guys have enjoyed the series and the episode and all that whatnot. Still got some slots open for new soldiers. And that's all that. So see you guys next time. Have a great day.